OGs.
I mean, obviously the slot, you know, it's one of the heroes that you can pick against the Juggernaut as a hero as well that can kind of be very hard to be IRA relocated gank upon. He's going to be incredibly slippery to deal with. OG ban out of the Timber Sort, a hero that we've seen Secret very flexible with in terms of the lane and the role that they run it. Now Secret with their final man.
Five seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Now.
Team Secret.
Ember Spirit.
OG's turn to pick.
He's another quite slippery hero, though. I mean, obviously, OG have to lasso.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah. It kind of feels like, in terms of drafts at the moment, I mean, OG, if they've still got a chance to kind of pick something up here. But it may be the kind of the problem that Secret had in the first game in terms of trying to get the kill onto Anna's Morphling. Now, this time around, it's going to be OG trying to catch up the Slark Ember. But at the same time, yeah, Ember, you know, if he gets the Battle Fury, if he gets those items, can be considered, you know, a way to deal with that. But he's got to get those core items. And, well, final pick for OG is going to be Fly on the Witch Doctor. So, Lawrence is going to have a lot of heals. Yeah, you're liking more what Secret's come from. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Absolutely, an MP Slark as well. I mean, across the board, really. Secret very much got comfortable here. I would say some of us OG as well. They do have kind of very strong, kind of classic OG lineup. But we'll see indeed how this one goes down, ladies and gentlemen, as we get ourselves into game two between Secret and OG. As the lanes start to come out. In fact, it's going to be a smoke movement from Secret. At the same time from OG as well. I mean, if this does end up in a bit of a fist fight at level one, do you favor a certain side here with the level one fighting? I could be in trouble. He has got a point in the leap. OG, there's a limit to how deep they want to go on that. So yeah, flame the Slark. Again, I mean, already, obviously, we're seeing just the heroes that they can't really make a go on. So they'll just force him back and head back towards the rune spot. This is going to mean that Secret can get themselves a free rune up top. OG will, of course, grab themselves the rune down bottom by the looks of it. And in terms of the lanes, it doesn't seem like we'll see anything too out of the ordinary. I'm going to have that mid lane matchup between... actually from OG.
I'll take that as gold given.
Oh, okay. I mean, looked a little bit because S4, yeah, as well, he headed up towards the top. And do you like this decision from Secret? They're running, the Slark on this top lane with the backup from Pi, and then having Forever on the safe lane. Yep. I mean, obviously, at the moment, Jerax, he's up there to help. Flies down on the bottom with S4. I mean, do you think we'll expect he just flies staying down here? try and make it hard for everyone at the start off, or will OG need to have the Witch Doctor up top as well? I mean, already, look at the pressure. They're coming in onto Nota. He's got Jarrett's coming across, but the Shadow Prison stacked. It's a couple in a DJ flight. He's up to the top lane. They're going to need all the help they can get, really, to allow Nota to have the save. And look at this. Immediately, MP, he says, you want to come up here? I'll go down there. And Secret immediately reacting to this lane movement from OG. Mid lane matchup, well, yet to talk about it, but Anna, 8-3 against mid ones, 3-1. Sully seems to be a bit of a tricky start here for the Ember Spirit on the mid lane, as Anna's starting to get ahead. Actually, no Blade Fury, and as I said that, he is in a lot of trouble. He's gone. So Puppy moving in just in time, reacting very nicely to the fact that Anna decided to use the Blade Fury aggressively. I mean, we're saying, you know, Anna was having a good time in CS. Maybe, you know, he just got a little bit too cocky there and went aggressive, and Puppy was there to punish it. Oh, now sweeping down towards the bottom. S got to be a bit careful himself. Why? He's just got out. Yeah, just now got enough mana for the option. And they can on point. Puppy and his Kunker. Strong. Two kills to start off for Secret. As the movements around the map are very successful. And as we said, you know, the mid lane, mid one was falling back a bit. So Puppy, he's got to keep this up. He's got to keep making these movements, putting the pressure on the lanes around the map and freeing up the space for MP, mid one, and Forever, of course, just to have that start that they need. Oh. I mean, in reaction to OG, they have both of their spots flying up, flying Jarex. I mean, Witch Doctor and Io, I guess that's one of the things, really. They can obviously do a good job at protecting No-Tail, but in terms of moving around the map, it's a lot harder for them to get stuff done in comparison to Pilot Eye and Puppy's Shadow Demon combo. He's got a haste to draw that. Rev. Is it a half one to go for? They will try for it. TP reactions coming through. The spins bringing Hotel down a little bit. Turns up. Hasn't quite got the mana for a torrent though, but at least does force them to back away. Rev might pop though. He's good. Oh. Very, very close indeed. But yeah, good P from Puppy. You know, you don't get the kill, but yeah, you manage to stop them and hold them off long enough to allow Axe to escape. Back towards the look at the lane still. Anna, even though he got knocked down, he really is having a very nice. Again, I say this, but he's going to go down. I think I've cursed Anna. Keep said he's having a nice time farming, and then he dies. I mean, mid one, finding a solo kill against the Jug. I mean, that shouldn't really happen in the mid lane, should it? Yeah. I was just gonna play this safer. I'm just gonna play again using the Blade Fury. Oh, if he dies again. Maybe if they get a torrent into the chains, he could have been in trouble. I mean, he's just played so aggressively in this mid lane. It has come back to bite him two times already. Radiance top tower is under attack.
take that.
I'm in a pie. Pie gets a disruption set up. I should be able to find a kill out of this one. No tell. He's not quite level 6. There's going to be no Song of the Cypher. Comes in, gets the call on to Fly. And comes Jarex as well, trying to see Fly. The heals doing quite a bit, in fact. Fly keeping himself alive here. Finally gets dug down. Get one, gets two. Even just get himself free. No tell falling low. He has got the mana for the... Oh, he's going to pussy out. Oh. He didn't want it. But still, two kills there for Ferev. Very nicely done there by the team. And next time when that happens, no tell, he'll have level 6, so he's going to have the song. And, you know, if someone was available then, those two kills don't happen. No tell, he allows you to disengage. Because as we saw with the heals, they were able to keep each other alive, the two supports, fairly long. So, you know, just buying time for no tell to just come in and song, you're going to be able to keep your supports alive. But obviously that wasn't to be the case with no tell, just on level 5, the time that they decided Secret made that play. MP could go back in. He's got the Shadow Dance. He can fully go for this one. He's falling a little bit low as he jumps into the Firefly. In fact, Puffy missing the Torrent. S4, so allowed to get out. Now 5-0 at the moment. Secret are getting the kills, but the farm's certainly there for OG's cause. No tell, giving a lot of protection at the start of the top lane. He's 52-11. Anna. Be it him going down twice in the mid lane, he's still second highest on the CS. Well, actually, over to there, we'll see how the kills just fire. And it's very, very close, really, across the cores. Pretty much the biggest difference being that there's obviously a bit of a gap between S4 and Ferev. And that's, of course, due to the fact that Ferev was able to get those two kills very nicely on the top lane. So it's given him a bit of a cash boost. And here we have Smoke Up, Secret, and they're looking to go. The question is, who do they find? Yeah, this is very hard for Secret to do something here. Nice here. No tell. Oh, actually, no tell's... Big Jerry still is going to be chased down and gone. No tell. He's not put a point in the song yet, so there's no chance of disengaging. Anna's going to come across. He has got an Omni Slash. Oh, she wants to be careful. Wow, with the lasso, he knows he can go. But again, Ferev comes in, takes one of the hits, and that's going to allow Midborn to get himself out by the looks of it. Ferev, he's going to try for TP out. Oh, the net's there to cancel it, so they will kill the axe. But Ferev going in, literally throwing his body out in order to allow Midborn to get himself away safely. Oh, still in the jungle. I mean, No-Tail's there. His team aren't, and Secret are. Jarex will turn up. Torrent's gonna miss. Mid one. See what they can go for. Here's the boat coming in onto Io. Jarex is out. And No-Tail still hanging around. Yeah, they're out now. Getting a lot down bottom. And as you said, yeah. Closing in on the Shadow Blade. A rev. Very close to his Blink Dagger. 1700 gold. OG need to try and slow down the pace of this game a little bit more. But no tell, obviously, because the farm is still very, very close. Because of the fact that they've managed to keep now, you know, in the jungle, they were being able to protect. They did lose lives around it. an hotel, being kept alive, and now moved down to this bottom lane. But MP, he's already got his eyes on, giving me a little bit of a go. TP's coming through, no tail and fluff. They've got to be careful there. Secret have three men in the neighborhood. Pi gets a disruption. They have the torrent and the boat. No tail. He hasn't. Obviously, he's still not got a. Now he's got a point in the song. That's a good job as well. Oh, they want to look for the turnaround. Yeah, Anna bought in by Jarax. The boat coming out. It's going to land. No tail, though. No tail. Being brought down Fed, though. MP trying to get back in position. Doesn't land the pounce. He's got Shadow Dance. He's not going to use it as again. Now he uses it. Looks towards Anna. At the same time, on the back of it all, S4 gets the lasso onto Puppy. OG finds the Kunkka kill. MP trapped. Grab the Omni from Anna just in time to dip down MP. Big kills for OG there. They turn around the fight perfectly. A fantastic relocate from Jarax. It's great decision there. You know, we saw Notel pops the song. We're like, he's not going to get out, but that's fine because OG, they were prepared to get themselves in and fight back.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
And they whip the combo. A little bit of a pass. They've sent everything out. They will get Anna into boat. Good call from Frev. The dunk a little bit early. I'm sure he's still dead. Oh, the healing ward. Healing ward. Oh, surely not. Surely not. There we go. He did. He gave him the right little round. OG now.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Okay. And this is an Argo as well. You know, no tail. He's on 3k gold, so the scuffles have been happening. He's been keeping himself alive mid lane. What the hell's going on? A bit of a deep dive as mid one and Puppy come in with the Tidebringer hit. They take down one. Mid one. Very low on the mana. He hasn't got enough mana to jump to the Remnant, so Notel and S4 can give him a bit of a chase down here. There's the lasso as S4 with the blue reveal, jumps in, brings one back. Now with the stick charges, he's got enough to jump once. Oh, he doesn't quite get himself down onto the river. He's got four stacks on him, slowing him down. Anna, gonna get this one more touch. There it is. S4 comes in, gets the final hit. They do take down the Ember Spirit there. As, I mean, Secret went in for that kill, but losing the Ember, absolutely not worth.
Gold for my chest. Invisibility.
Oh, he's got that Shadow Blade done now. So now he can try and do exactly that. He's coming across. Has he got his eyes on? He's coming between the towers. He's looking to Anna, but Anna, he's got a Blade Fury and an Omni, so there's no way you're getting that kill on your own. Yeah. No tail. 500 gold away from that relic, so that first big hurdle nearly complete and at a very good timing as well. Now top lane flies on his own, and well, there's eyes on him. He'll go for the death ward. And quite aptly so, as they quickly finish him off.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
I mean, they're in the no-tail basket, but which can often be fine. And yeah, mid lane, a bit of a jump in. Look at S4 into the combination. And he has got the dunk, not quite able to bring him down low enough. S4, can he play his way out of here? Puppy's actually not any mana. So S4 is going to get him out. S4, get away up. Everything is thrown down upon him. MP, he really wants this kill for team. S4. Oh, he's gone the wrong way. Oh, get the career instead, lad. Oh, he's not. He wants to get out. He doesn't want to risk it. He can't afford to go for plays that are going to cost his life. S4 playing his way out of that. Oh my goodness. I mean, yeah.
Dire's structures are fortified.
He's nearly got the Radiance. He just picked up the Relic. Yeah. This is danger territory. You know, once No-Tail hits that timing, it's... Secret have really set up the ante. Bottom lane. They've got their eyes on this. They need to get everyone in position. He's moving over with the Firefly, but yeah, immediately. Mid one actually remnants out. Not that far away, though. They know that he's still around. And they get the Blink Lasso. They've got their eyes on him. Yeah, he's going to be able to get out. They don't want to go that deep. Yeah, they see with this one. I think, yeah, they saw Puppy around. So they felt that, you know, Secret could be there in full force. So OG just playing it safe, making sure that they don't go for anything too risky. And there we have it. Radiant's now complete on No-Tail. 17 minutes, absolutely fine time to have it. You know, he's top of the net worth board. This is great. Yeah. Yeah, big call as well. Just catches him on the clip, it's enough. There's the quick dunk and Anna's down. Coughs like that, exactly what Secret need to achieve, and then they need to find something off the back of it. But yeah, a lot of stun on for Rev to make those plays. Get himself those calls, because as we're seeing, if you land a call on any of these heroes, Secret can kill them. You know, Puppy just lands combo and bam, there's the torrent, the boat, a little bit off port. Fly will still go down.
Trickster's Rune of Illusion.
I mean, I guess that's the thing as well, you know, Secret, they don't really have anyone that can hit towers that well at the moment. I mean, you've always got an Ember that's gone bots first, and now building into the Battle Fury. MP has a Shadow Blade, going for the Echo Saber, but still, you can't take towers at a very good rate. And look at this again. OG's movements, if they can get a Ember kill off the back of this. I mean, S4, he's going to have eyes on it. Looks like the team already bailed out. They do have a relocate. Relocate in 10 seconds. They can wait 10 seconds. Jarrett's can bring someone in. Who's he near? Well, he's only near Fly. They have Lasso on Death Ward. Maybe. He's got to be quick, S4. And we have relocate now. He's instantly... Yeah. Plays it out. And, you know, this is, you know, we've seen OG create a lot of space with S4 being elusive. This is exactly vice versa. You know, mid one, attracts the attention of four heroes, relocate as well, and he just plays his way out of there. So spaces are opened up around the map. Puppy's allowed a bit of a chance to get some levels up. MP, going to look to see if he can find any kind of stragglers as he sweeps across. Actually, carrying around the gem as well on the Slark, so see, looking to get some of that map control. He's got the song available. I'm gonna see him make a go, but immediately, yeah, No-Tail songs. And teased out. Oh, the Torrent! Puppy! He got it just outside of the range. And now looking for the chase down with the Battle Hunger. Then a lot of trouble. There's still a tier 1, so TP back up there, but it's not quick enough. They'll get the kill. A Puppy. I mean, that Torrent range, it is pretty redonkulous. And we're seeing the power of it there against the Naga Siren. Big, big go there for Secret. And it... Yeah. Oh, he was! I would have loved to see his face in real life. He was probably like, alright, boys, we're... Oh, shh. God damn! Yeah, that's close. Alright, we go. Alright, we'll get the tower now. Get ourselves a bit more money into the bank. Dire's middle tower is under attack. Oh yeah. Oh, hang on. Oh, actually, but... Oh, but Fly, he's not going to be as lucky. Oh, the Dukes. I don't think they did. Fly's fine. Yeah, it is. It must have been out of range. Puppy did. I didn't see Anna either. And in fact, Anna, he sees Puppy. Oh, Puppy, he's been spotted under the wall. Relocate coming in. Got the armlet. Well, let's see if he could... I mean, back for it. Managed to find a kill onto the Naga Siren, but we've got the eyes on Puppy here. No, he doesn't survive this. He finally goes down. He tries to go for the armlet, but there's no toggling through a Blade Fury. But yeah, more importantly... Yeah? Oh my goodness, what a trade indeed for Secret, yeah. This is a let, you know, this is a point, you know, Ember Spirit on par with the Radiant Naga's farm. Mid one, is that the, that is the completed Battle Fury. So 22 minutes in, Battle Fury and bot's done.
Top tower is under attack.
I got eyes on top again. Anna coming across, but mid one. He has remnants out. They can just play around with this. Ooh. Look at this OG. Tries to... Oh, that cool! That cool though, Forev comes in onto three, but the song from Naga Hotel just in time. They've lost Fly. Oh, it was a good job Notel was there, because OG... We're about to be absolutely crushed. If Mibon gets in, one slide of fist with that Battle Fury, that's three dead.
Yeah.
Dire's top tower has fallen.
Oh, puppy. He hits the torrent, they go for Anna, he has got the Blade Fury, and they don't quite at the moment have enough damage to take him down before he's able to get away. But MP, you know, off the back of that bit of it, he's got 2.7k gold, he himself, he's getting big. As you said, Secret, as we're seeing, if they can hit those cools, OG can be caught in very awkward positionings, and well, we can see that Secret want to fight. You know, next item for the Slark, he just goes straight for the BKB. You know, with that BKB done, he gets himself in there. There's not a lot that OG can do to kill the Slark at this point. He's kind of the equivalent of Anna's Morphling that we saw in game one. Oh, forever. Again, I mean, Anna, I kind of switched away and then went back. He came fairly far out to the creep wave, and Secret, it just jumped straight back in on him. And these are kills you cannot afford to be given away. Anna's really, you know, he's starting to fall down a little bit in terms of the net worth. Mib one has the blink dagger as well, so he's going to become even harder to catch out. You know, we said that Secret had these slippery cores of the Ember Spirit and the Slark, and even more so now. Yeah, MP very much close to picking up that BKB. So OG, they need to play for the core. They need to keep the game going, have no tail pushing out the lanes. It is a fairly hard high ground to break, but it's not impossible. You know, if the axe gets in there and hits a hero with the cool, you can break the base. Just the issue is obviously taking down the structures at a good speed, but you can definitely kill OG if you find that opening.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Thank you. Oh, look at the net worth as well. Look at the net worth difference overall. Quite a sizable one, to over 10k. Yeah.
Radiant's top tower has fallen. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Oh boy. Right, we're gonna have a quick pause here. Yeah, OG. They need more time for Notel. And he is still there, you know, it's a similar story into the way that, you know, OG were able to bring the game on because they had, and having such a great game. This time around, it's Notel who's up there, but he still needs more items. Yeah. OG, probably be best to keep the resources defending the high ground, and they may just have let this one go. And as we see, it takes quite a bit of time to take down a tower. But OG, yeah.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, which is good. OG know this. Look at S4's position. He wants them to TP back. OG wants to try and fight this. As the Blade Fury TP from one. Okay, with Anna tipping out, OG realized they've got to get themselves away. Rax just out on the sidelines. Yeah, it looked like they wanted to maybe try and go for a pick, say if Secret sent, like, just the Axe down or the Ember down to clear the lane, but sending two down, that was a little bit too much for OG to feel that they could jump in and deal with, so managing to get out. Yeah. It's probably the Link side, maybe. Yeah, protected from the lasso. I mean, then, you know, Lincoln's Blink. He's very hard to take down. I mean, as we're seeing at the moment, if Ferev hits cool, gets the spin, we're still at a stage of the game where damage isn't really the issue for Secret. You know, they have that amount of control, a slight fist and a couple of spins, and the combo coming from Puppy. That's enough to take down G's heroes. They really are. Notel doing his best to keep the game rolling. And it's allowing them this window to keep on top. S4 on the top. Oh, Pi. He is probably dead. I don't think there's no way he gets out of this one. Easy pick for S4. He played the long game. He was hanging around for a long time. And paying off as he gets himself a free kill. Pings. Oh, look for this towards top, going into S4, the copper forever there. The song is not going to save him as the boat comes crashing in. Can they turn this? OG, eyeing this one up. Oh, here we go, having a go at it all. BKB pop by MP. In fact, the Omni Slash rips through forever. And now chasing down with the Blade Fury, trying to go for more. Mid one has to remnant himself out of there. They're going to look to get a bit of a lock on. Anna Yeah. Got the backup of the team. Uppy turns around for the Tidebringer hit, but they're coming in hard. MP turns up. He hasn't got the Shadow Dance. It's still on cooldown. He's got to run. Anna, Jarex chasing down the Slark here. Pi trying to come in to slow the mid one. Comes back in with a slight. The chains onto Jarex, but they've lost the Slark. Pilot Eye drops the Demonic Purge onto Anna, but they can't kill him. They've just got to disrupt him and run. Mid one. Remnants away, Pilaya dies, still being chased by OG. Puppy goes for a Torrent's Holdback, no tip. Anna follows through, takes down a third kill. Mimmon's come back into it, trying to finish off No Tail, but No Tail TP back to safety. The illusion's near killing Jarex there from Pilaya dies disruption. But at the end of the day, OG finding three big kills, a massive cash swing, and yeah, the gem as well switching hands. Yeah, big plays for No-Tail. It really feels, yeah, the lack of push is the kind of the Achilles heel for Secret. And OG realized this and are able to stall the game out. For the time being, Perev coming across. He's going to go for a bit of a play as he jumps in to Anna. And he's got it. That is a very nice kill for the Axe to find solo there. And being coming across. Jarrett realizes that there's a way. OG back towards the high ground, making sure no one gets caught out here.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Line's being drawn by Jarex. I mean, No Tail knows this. He said he's got the money for the Octarine as well. And with that, I mean, the lane situation is going to get even worse for Secret. They obviously have the Axe. I mean, Axe, Kunker, and Ember can clear ways out. But to do that, they've got to be in different parts of the map. And that's not great for the way that Secret are trying to play. And the way that they're going to be able to tackle the fact that each and every fight, No Tail, able to turn it around with the Song of the Siren. There we go, the jump in forever. Oh, they've gone in on an illusion. The illusion's out for sure. Secret, they need to find a proper kill. And they've lost Ferev. He's going to be the first to pop fly on the sideline with the Death Ward. There's the Omni coming out, but MP has the Shadow Dance to survive. There's the Song from No Tail, looking to reset the fight around the Shadow Dance duration. See what they can do with this one. Are they going to try and go in, or are they going out on the side of it all? Anna could be in trouble. Torrented MP and Puppies around him. Anna's going to fall. Cuss bouncing between Pi and MP. MP trapped up. Pi's out. See, they can't get him out. No, he's gone as well. Mid one, the last man surviving here. Can he actually escape? S4 is going to be, look, he's going to go for this chase. Mid one turns around. He has one remnant left. And actually, Bob managing to pop her four there with that slight. So, S4 standing a bit too close for comfort. Mid one able to survive in that bit of a blow up there. Going the way of OG. Taking down that S4 barrel at the end. So he's just clipped by the slight. But still, big fight. So don't relocate either. He's thinking about it. I think it's No Tail as well. Oh, he's trying. He really wants it! He really wants it! Oh! And he's gonna get it! Oh, he got it! He gets out! Oh my god! Oh my goodness. OG did not expect that. Yep. Mid one, 6-1-9, and he's not done yet. He jumps in. They've got the chains onto S4. S4, he's going to go down. There'll be a buyback from No Tail. Anna coming in. He has the Omni available. There's the Song. Now, what you need now is... You need black hole. You need a vacuum. You ain't got it. It's a secret. They'll walk off to slumber. In fact, well, they might want to get themselves still stuck in. Now look at her, Anna. Anna, lining up against mid one. Playing around this, dancing beautifully between the damage, but Puppy's down. They do manage to bring down the Kunkka. And so with that, with one man gone, Secret will back off. But yeah, mid one. And come on, the slide of fish. Pi, kill the illusion. No. Oh, the illusion burned too much as Pi Lai Dai drops. Mim survives. The ninja. 7-1-9. It's pretty much, it feels like it's going to become this kind of epic matchup between No Tails Naga and Mid One's Ember. And at the moment, as we've seen, if Mid One can play this aggressive and calculated, I don't know what you're going to do. Yeah. Better. Yeah.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
No Tail did drop it on death, but yeah. Yeah, he didn't. It was kind of like more focused on just getting the hell out, I think. He was like, oh crap, I got the kill, I gotta get out of here. So yeah, didn't really have time to play around with his inventory. Basher done now on MP. It's obviously still being turned upon a little bit by the whole kind of fight between the Ember and the Nog, but the Basher. Can certainly do a little bit more in terms of just locking down one of the backliners, causing issues for the supports. Of course, this is nice as well. The old Shadow Demon stealing the Naga illusions and give yourself a bit of damage to push the waves back. As indeed Pi Lai Dai can do that. Oh my goodness, though. 24:15, 38 minutes in. Top. Ooh. I mean, they actually relocated across as well for that. It's a hard catch for them to get. They popped the Lincolns, but get the follow through lasso in time. As Mid One's reactions, absolutely instant now. He's going to be fine. He blinks out. Barev, he came across as well. But of course, one thing, yeah, that's why the Shadow Blade's so brilliant here on Frev. We are seeing the illusions from No Time, making it very hard for Frev to get jumps. Now, yeah. Secret. I'm gonna smoke up here. I'm gonna have Mid One push in the mid lane. And we'll see if they get a catch. MP to lead the way of the Shadow Blade for Ev to fall as well. OG. Keeping themselves up on the high ground. Jax does have he has a relocate. And he is gonna try and use it to save Anuil. Brings him out the sideless. Good relocation there from Jackson now. For reinitiation. He has got another call. I mean, he actually gets the blink out. He's going to be able to get himself away safely. And OG, can they actually find a catch here? Chasing them down, they'll go for the Omni. Good bounce on MP, but he's going to survive through it. Or Pardai looks to be the one to suffer here. Brev comes back in with cool, but he's taking so much damage. Anna, is he going to survive this? Back away, he lives. And now S4 with the left. Oh, to MP. Tail with the triple kill as 4 fall on Secret. Again, it's these decisions to pop the song to get themselves stuck back in there. It's absolutely running into pieces. A good Omni as well. I mean, it was kind of split damage, but it worked out for Mana because OG had the potential to finish off those low health heroes. And 4 dead.
has fallen. Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Oh boy, indeed. Now I know where they can. Yeah, they don't even have tier 2 bottom to TC. I can team to the tier 2 mid when they're back up, It's gonna be two. OG. Get themselves the Roche. It's gonna be scan out secret. They know that it's going on. But very limited options in terms of getting them in time to fight. Now we have it. Aegis into the hands of Ana. Back to base. This is, it's a bit of a sad game for Pyte to play in, isn't it? It's got to be so, so careful where it comes to. Now, oh, I mean, Nota. Butterfly picked up as well. Seen already. I mean, obviously, there was that flashy play from mid one. They were able to kill him, but now Nota playing the fights on the back line, allowing Secret to kind of bully go in on someone else, and then turning the fights around. How are we seeing mid one do it? So, okay, so mid one did finish off the MKB with that Demon, rather than going for the completed Daedalus first. He is prepared. Yeah, Radiant's miss and Butterfly. Yeah. Regenerate. Now look at this. There's micro move everywhere. In the mid, in the jungle, and it's also at the top. There's a reason why our teams are banning out No-Tails Naga. And OG just played so well. They created so much kind of an area of safety at the start. We just saw, you know, obviously OG just playing defensive. They were pretty much like a full man in their own jungle. Just to make sure No-Tail gets the start he needs. And you can see why that works out for them here. But as you said, you know, Secret are able to somehow fight around the song. Eight Naga out of the fight. Can certainly kill off the rest of the lineup, but it's OG coming in aggressive. Smoking up. Secret want to try and turn. Forev leading the way. He'll get the call onto Ana, but the Illuder's just ripped into Vivid's MP. Takes the healing ward out. Now turns towards Ana. Good turret from Puppy, but still, the damage just isn't quite there. The slight brings OG down fairly low. OG survive. Secret have to back themselves back up to the base. Get themselves ready to go. Every lane being controlled by No-Tail. You can see mid one, he's just desperately trying to pull a lane away from them on the bottom. We'll see around this bottom was just to make sure that they're not in a situation where pressure's coming in from all sides. So that's what No-Tail is doing his best to do. Yeah. And S4. Yeah, I guess that's the one to Pi. That'll be one. Now with the song, ooh. Looks like he's gonna be fine. MP again doing what mid wanted down bottom. He's now pushing up the top lane. And OG, we'll look to back up. That was because he just... he's looking at MP. Could certainly try and play around. I just straight up, yeah. He's out. I mean, is that the end of the game now for Secret, do you feel? But they just have to somehow make sure they're not in a position where all three lanes are in on them.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Thank you. I saw him in again, OG. I've got S4, the last off cooldown. Missed to get, but they have actually spotted out Pi. He's underneath the ward. And there comes S4 coming across. My tries for the TP. 4 off Pi. Getting caught out by OG. Desperately trying to get a bit of vision out.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
He's got the rem. He's good. But, yeah, putting the pressure on. So the fact that they managed to pull a lane all the way around there, that's something. But they need a little bit more than just that. So OG are knocking on the doors. There'll be a jump for Rev trying to get it. But the S4, but the last test is going to get broken. So he's fine. Axe is not going to be dragged out. Out of the base, and OG still just standing on the doorsteps. Pi, oh, tried to go for disruption, instead opting to just take the Naga illusions. So they've got something to push back the wave a little bit. And then just play Fury's up now. There's the jump for Rev. Gets the call. BKB from MP. Jumping in onto Ana. No Tail pops the song. MP's going to be held back by that net. And now the Omni. It comes back through. But they're actually doing minimal damage, of course, to Rev. Rev now finally falling a little bit. But the disruption comes out from Pi. Ezra trying to get himself out of there. Rev finally falls. Death Ward's been popped down by Fly. MP jumps away. Yeah, buyback from Rev now. OG managing to force that out of the Axe. And they're still hanging out outside of the base. And everyone's trying to go for Ion on the back lines, but he's being healed up. He can't quite finish it off. And again, no tail. The song, and they're just going to TP. They're disengaging. They're already sort of a few heroes fairly low. They don't want to stick around for this. They can just reset. But to go again at a late date, and as you mentioned, damage has already been done. They take the tier 3 down mid lane, tier 3 down on the bottom, their Axe already taking damage. So OG can just wait, get those ults back online, go in again, and then try secret again on this base push. And they need a Rapier Ember. That's what they need. We need to see mid-1 pick up the Rapier. Surely. Surely it's becoming Rapier territory. But I guess the thing with a Rapier is it's so hard because one bad positioning, the Naga just songs, and then they just walk up to you, even though you're on the back lines, and then kill you, and the Rapier's gone. It's again, it's so hard for them. Oh my. Eyes on for Rev. He is absolutely surrounded at the moment. They're going to jump onto him. And Blade Fury checking out the bow for Rev. Still trying to go in. The slight comes through for mid one. Nearly taken down Fly, but he can't quite get the final touch on it. And indeed, they've lost that. That's a dieback. On the back line, they killed No-Tail! They killed No-Tail! Well, that's pretty huge. If No-Tail doesn't die there, OG very well go for the push. Oh, hang on. The support, sir. They are falling so quickly to the Radiant Spur. But the fact that No-Tail dies there means the Secret have another chance. Because if OG have the full fight, man, and Axe is down without buyback, their base is looking to be in a lot of trouble. He's got something. He's brought the relic. He brought the relic. He's not brought the whole rapier. That's MP's Demon Edge, yeah. So it is going to be rapier soon. Keep on manning up for the cause. MKB's been picked up on MP. I mean, both of these calls are scariest. We've seen if they get a latch onto No-Tail, I think No-Tail just kind of underestimated the speed that they can kill him. You know, he starts to go for the song, but yeah. forever. Oh, they get the jump onto Anna. He needs backup. He's helped the song. Comes through. We'll hold them down. Secret. Let's see what the plan is, Anna. Turns around, draws the Abyssal, Omni comes for it, they'll take down Pareb. Pareb out again for 70 seconds. Puppy pulling low as well, they'll find the Kunkka. MP trying to man, has to jump away, has to get himself out of here, but S4, gonna be hot on the case. Anna jumping forward as well. They'll get two kills. I mean, that's more than enough. Maybe they can find themselves another. Pylai die stuck in the middle of it all. OG, 9-3. Roshan's up and at the ready. Mid one. Oh, it's gonna be a nice global coconut here. Where did it go? There it is. Oh. But either way, three heroes down, OG back to the Roche pit. They should be able to get this no trouble at all. And the courier's being sent out. Yeah, mid one's got enough now for, nearly got enough for rapier on buyback, so he just goes in now. I mean, at the end of the day as well, even if he has buyback on top of the rapier, it's still gonna be hard for him to play back to losing it. But there we have it. There's the purchase. Rapier's now into the game. We'll see if this is what Secret need to change to one around. You know, they may have kind of lost, obviously, the envy of the past, but mid one, he's stepping up. He wants to be the new Eternal Envy. Which I don't know if it's a good or bad. We'll find out. It's going to be a good thing or a bad thing. Roshan has fallen to the dark. Oh boy. 3 minutes in, 25 to 20 to the gold graph. Up and down. Very much down for the side of Secret G with a 14-8 gold lead. And Mill, it's all about how he plays. I do like what Mid1's doing though, because he has the farm. I think what he's going to do, he's not going to pick that rapier up maybe till he buybacks. Or no, maybe that, or even until he dies. Yeah. Maybe. I mean, because at the moment he does enough damage, and losing it on the first life, you know, you come back and you've not like got that big surprise punch. So he may go either way with it, but at the moment at least he is leaving it in the fountain. Oh, OG. Oh, really, it's the song.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. Tower has fallen.
OG. If they want to get in position, they can do it. They can song, waltz up, and look for a fight. But it's very hard and it's very risky. You know, they get a bad song out. You know, they don't get a kill off the back of it, and suddenly they're in such a vulnerable position, and Secret can just kind of then clean them up. So a lot of pressure rests on No-Tail's shoulders at the moment. So far, he's certainly moving up to what the team needs him to accomplish. He's got himself to this point. Now he's just got to continue to perform at this high mechanic level.
Top tower is under attack.
A bit of a waiting game now. I mean, as you said earlier, this could be one of those games that it's hard to put a timer on. These are losers. Oh, a couple more of those and the ranged reactor is gone. I mean, Bitborn at this stage, he may be able to start building a bank of rapiers in the base. I mean, is there any kind of big item for OG that you can see kind of coming around the corner that could help them in the base breaking?
Radiant's middle barracks are under attack.
Yeah. Buffing up these illusions is... And there we have it. So they themselves a ranged rack, so at no cost at all. But yeah, this Naga... I mean, a 50k now for this stage. This is ridiculous. And what's GPM? It's got to look pretty good, yeah. 956 GPM on Notel. That is... That's some crazy numbers. I mean, even for a Naga. Even for a good Naga game, that is a good Naga game. Yeah. And other players, that might have tilted you, but Notel's kept us cool. Always find the rapier into his hands by mid bomb. He has grabbed. He doesn't need it. He doesn't need the boots. He needs to jump around like a ninja. Hit those crits. And he's golden. But he really needs to hit those crits. He needs to hit big ones. OG. Still hesitant on pushing into the base. It could hold this off. There's a scan there from Secret. I know that they're coming in. They're gonna try and commit. There we go, they jump in on the backliners, but immediately they cross up and there's the song. This is the song usage. Was OG gonna come this? They could actually Notel's TP. It was the bait TP! It was the BTP Secret! They wanna fight this coming in! Swallow dance from P, the boat lines through. Notel's still sticking around, not to fall. That's a S4. Get a lasso though, onto MP. Drag back into the depth board from Floppy. MP comes out, P's down though. Does have a buyback available, use a BJ from Revs as well. He does not have buyback. S onto mid one, in a lot of trouble. Oh, the slide, the remnant mid one survives. Wall jump, but he's out of the game, saving him from the radius, but he will live. But gets a triple kill. There's a buyback on Puppy. They've only got Axe on the sidelines at the moment. So OG still get the kills, but mid one keeping himself alive. Song again, mid one just sits away from that slumber. This time, Notel. Notel, Pete, I mean, he is. It's the TP. He's taunting them with it. Oh, if he gets caught there by the chains, he had nothing. He had no mana. They kept them up. Oh my goodness. Right, so. And it gets a triple kill. To force out two buybacks. I think that's pretty much the big win for, you know, for OG there. Next push, Slark and Kunker Puppy and MP will not be able to have that second try. Oh, it's the second rapier. It's the second rapier. It's the is it the back rapier or is it double? Is he gonna stack him? It's the backup rapier. He's not gonna have two out at once. Oh, hi. I mean, that, well, we haven't really noticed Garax. He's got an E-Blade.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And it does save someone from a slot, you know. There we have, onto the rack, starting to finish it off. Demonic just drops onto Anna. P wants to try and go in, but there's the song. There's the song from Notel. It is going to be... Puppy might be able to get show on. Nah, he's not gonna commit. Oh my goodness. Puppy now has an I like this. Puppy's gone back for an ether lens. Obviously, 62 minute ether lens, not something you see every day. But that X range, the chance you can get inside of the song. And oh, what's this? MP of Forever! Okay, they'll get the jump onto Anna, but they're a little bit far away from the team. Secret, they're making their way over Torrent onto Anna. The jump over the slide. Anna being below the board from Puppy. It's onto the jump, but Anna, he's going to be saved by Jerex. Anna bought this one. And the Secret, they've got to get themselves out for Rev. He really can't afford to go down again. He's to the sidelines, but as fast him, jumps in off the axe. The sun comes through. Oh, there we have it. Anna, he's so low. But again, the song saving Anna on the Juggernaut. No tail. Oh my goodness, Naga Siren play. He's even brought another flying carrier. He's just so much money. This game is getting off the charts, and in fact, this fight might not be over. MP. Let's see if we can find anything. That's not going to be the case. But this is bad news for Secret again. They're losing Axe. Oh, he stacked him. Yeah, he's going. Ah, he keeps it. Keep it out. He is going all in. He is going all in. And you 25 seconds before Axe is back up. I mean, the thing is as well, Axe, he does have buyback available in terms of the timing. It's just the board issue. If they have a fight and still are able to get like one or two kills, chances are Axe is going to have the money to bring himself back in for a second time. But they need to find a kill in these fights. No, it's just not allowing them to deploy. Has to be careful. Oh, he's good. Oh man. Okay, gonna say Midbomb was walking around with two raping crit, and the crit is pretty key. He actually now gets rid of the Lincoln's bit to pick up the crit. The jump onto Anna. He takes back the song again, coming out from No-Tail. It allows Anna to be relocated out safely. No-Tail TP's out again, and you know, OG come in, and as soon as they realize fight's bad, they can get out every single time. Yeah. Oh, for it. He's caught Jerex tower here. He should be able to take him down. It's going to be used up. In fact, the turret on this slash Jerex. He's going to find it. Rev's out again. He's down 35 seconds. Move on. Take down Fly. Up, he throws out the boat, but he himself's going to pay it. Can he toggle his way out this one with the armlet? No. The bash comes through. Anna will get it. A double kill for Mid. Midborn managed to take down two supports. They still need a little bit more. Saying that, just force OG again to back away. Secret, they're two men down without buyback. It is a bit of a slideshow. I think the servers are struggling with the time. The fact this game is going late. It's been played halfway across the world. It's getting a little bit crazy here. A mid one. Two raiders and Daedalus. 8.8k as well. I mean, we talk about the net worth of the Naga, but the mid one's certainly up there. 16k gold on Ona. Yeah. Oh boy. And OG, they're gonna go for Rosh, and of course they'll get, you know, with the amount of pressure that Secret have on them, they can't get out. Oh boy. The pressure certainly has been on for Secret for the last, feels like 40 minutes of this game. And Graf, well, they managed to level it out at a 25 key, K deficit. So, that's some kind of a good news. They've slowed down the lead, but, of course, it is OG. Absolutely miles ahead at this point in terms of value. But all that value is on this Naga. And as we see, No-Tail, he can't really necessarily get in a man fight. He just has to play as he has done, allow him to get out. And it is indeed a third Rabia being purchased. What? Is this the backup Rabia? Let's see if it fits into his kit. Actually, got a smoke up here, Secret. Behind one. It looks to be back up for now. They can get this wraparound. Puppy. He needs the combo. He needs time. He needs Forev to hit Paul. Forev. Leading him from behind. Yeah, sure, the smoke gets to. Something's up. The disrupt immediately. Forev gets one of the back gunners. They'll look to just down fly first. The E Blade is going to keep Blade alive. And again, the song coming out. Gonna provide some time for OG, but OG, they're a little split up, but they're in the boat. Coming flying across, and they've found S4. Secret, finding one kill to start the fight off here. They're gonna be able to find anything else. MP has his eyes on Jarrax, but Jarrax reloads. There'll be a buyback from S4. Forev is looking for this flight kill. And we'll get it. The two down OG, two down on Secret. And buyback's coming up from both sides. Oh boy, but look at this, MP, Hexstar push coming in, MP's out, he's got buyback, he has got buyback available, and it was it straight away, but they're still Kunkka down, MP had an answer BKB, no doubt, cleaning out, jump is there, the call as well, no doubt, down mid ball comes in, he's got damage, turns out, 90 seconds, looks like he's down more, S4, retreating back up to the north. Oh boy. MP. Oh! That crit! Jax just literally got his part. And now, the ball himself could be in trouble. Now he's got the relocate out, but he's going to come back to this point. If the top lane is secret, they're stepping it up. They're keeping up the ante. They'll actually cut across. Jax is relocate back down to bottom in 1 second. He goes, but there they are. They're prepared for him. MP will finish him off with the dart pack. So Secret getting kills. Pushing out, but as you said, what stands between them and Mega Creeps? It is just, yeah, this one ranged Rax. And I mean, it's a ranged Rax, Wakey. That is going down from illusion push. And there's no location. What? Where? Oh, yeah. How many... No, he's got one there. He's got one on him. Oh, wait, no, he picked up the one in the... he has lost a rapier. Oh, okay, Axe recovered it, yeah. Okay, Axe is just holding it for the time being. Yeah, pops it out, and it's still in the hands of mid one. The three rapiers still on the side of Secret. And this is... Secret are coming in with push. Dire's middle tower is under attack. No. There's Song. No, looking for the setup. Mid 1 and P very close together. It's all about S4's jump. Can he find anyone? No, they all blink out. In fact, they're trying to hit down Nota. They know without the Song, this is a good time for them to fight. They can get Ash. OG back up behind the towers. See, can they with this push? There is a game 3. It would be quite the win if they could. They're fighting with over 30,000 in favor of OG. Somehow Secret managing to keep themselves relevant in this game. And this is it. If they can break the base, it will be absolutely incredible. It's gonna be so hard. OG, they've kept composure for pretty much the whole game. It started to shake a little bit in that last fight. Oh god, he's trying to go for the setup here. He's coming. No Tail, he's going right around them on his own. And in fact, they're going to look for him. No Tail trying to juke it out in the tree line. Secret, they've come in, they've found him. No Tail just sulks, walks himself into an awkward position, and he's gone. Still giving up your lifeblood at this point. I mean, they have created this Mega Creep. They get the Mega Creep, but No Tail just goes in and throws himself to the house. Man, But that would be ideal. If they can get an Naga buyback out this time. Oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy. Mib one nearly got the bank for a fourth Raper. And then you can carry two, have two as a backup if it needs to be. There's the two rapiers there, of course, sitting in the deck. Ready for round two, if it is required. Buyback status, I think that's the stat that we were wondering about at the moment. Let's get it up for you boys at home. And as we can see, still a couple of minutes before MP and Pylodi buyback available again in terms of time. And Puppy is very much far away from buyback for Rev. Only 100 gold away from it. So Secret need a couple more minutes. Then they'll be in a position where they've got two lives to play with. I mean, just look at this. This is an OG, a team that has mega creeps. But at the moment, you know, without the Nagra life, they have to wait in the base. They have to stay. Mike! Oh, man. Have you looked at the gems in OG's base? Wow, this is... Puppy. We'll see. I see the counterplay for Rev. He getting the call onto Jarex. Jarex will be used up. Anna jumps in on Pylod Eye. Pylod Eye's out. Can she finish off Jarex? They will. Can they get the kill with the Omni Slash from Anna onto Rev? Falling low. Post the possession call. It's not going to keep him alive. He's out. And indeed, with the killing god, he just got enough back. And we have the jump in. There's four being focused, but Alexi back away. There's the buyback now from Rev. OG managed to force Secret to back. And the buyback now used by Rev. Oh man, 73 minutes into this game. It still certainly is OG's game to win, but Secret are showing us that they're still managing to just get the situation going in the way that they're allowed to try and find these plays. Oh, he picked them all. He's taken them all. Three rapiers, Daedalus, Battle Fury, he's good to go. We're seeing crits hitting the 3k, yeah. He's critting for higher than my MMR. Oh boy. But the waves, they're pushing in. OG really has the pressure being pushed up against Secret now. And they're taking tier 4s. I mean, the tier 4s are pretty much both down in the mid lane. Secret, they may just lose this game to illusion spam on the Ancient. Oh no, Rev does not have buyback here. He's caught out. There's no axe. Oh my goodness, and Anna jumping in onto MP slot. Pikabi tries to turn with the top. Secret, Anna pulling low. Pilot guy with the disruption. Oh, it's gonna allow Anna to get the blade off. Anna's able to back away. The Ancient's starting to take damage. They don't have this axe. Secret. And the last chance here. The crit's even not enough damage at the moment. They've got so much heal. OG. They need a massive sleight of fist. Oh, S4 looking for the lasso. Hex is in mid one. Mid one, hexed up. He needs some kind of a set. Mid one, big focus. He's down. He hits the deck. Oh no, the FI's back. He's got to do something big with this. The song comes through. They did manage to kill S4. The rapiers are down though. OG onto the Ancient MP. He comes through. Focuses Jarex. He's managing to keep them off Anna and Fly. They come back in. Just looking to hit the Ancient, but they've lost the IO. Anna, big focus. The Ancient's going down though. OG, they've died.